Welcome to Electro-Tech Ug. We are going to engage in a percolator repair session. Please subscribe, like and comment and get your tools ready.
Here the first step is to perform, shall perform a conductor test on the fuse to check whether it's working. Then the next one is a continuity test of the neutral from the plug to the bass. It's working. To test from the live of the plug to the bass. Yeah, then you can see. So if they are all working, then it's now time to open our percolator.
So the next step is to get the screwdriver and unscrew the bass. Make sure that you do it with vigilance. So use the appropriate screwdriver to do so. Next, we have to test for the resistance of our heater or the coil, and for a working coil it should display some resistance on the multimeter. Then you check the rings on the thermostat for both the live and the neutral. Once the first tests are done, go ahead and test the switch. You will start by unscrewing the percolator handle cover and then detach it. Next, unscrew the switch from the handle carefully and as well remove it. The rusting on the screw is normally brought about the steam that is directed to the bimetallic strip. So when you are unscrewing, do it with extra care in order not to damage the switch. So remove the switch from the handle and then as well remove the ring that always keeps the switch in position or that supports the triggering of the switch. And as you can see, those are our contacts. In most cases, the discontinuity is always brought about the corrosion, since the contacts are made out of copper, so they always corrode. So to remove it, you get either sandpaper or something that can use to scrap off the corroded material. Yeah, I'm using a tester, so for your case you can use sandpaper or any other material that can remove it, and we are doing so to make sure that the contacts are in a normally closed position, because for the on state they are always in contact, and for off they are always in disconnection. So make sure that they are in the contact state. Once the contacts have been realigned, we then check for continuity of both contacts. So you do a check and then you put back the ring and reassemble your switch. So make sure that you clean those two terminals very well to remove that corroded material. Then we trip our switch on and off and see if it is doing what it is supposed to do, that is being on and off at different times. So for our case, the multimeter has shown it. Then go ahead and put back the switch on the handle and put back the cover and as well screw it. Once everything is done, put back the cover and don't forget to put the indicator bulb in its original position. Then you have to align the screws according to their positions. Then we do the final step of testing. Yeah, for any inquiries, put them in the comment section. And thank you for watching.